it should not be less than 10 days. I do a lot of transfers, so I have just kept a data where at times, you know, you start with a higher dose and the patient already has levels of estrogen and she develops a good endometrium by day 9. But I think then we usually do P4 level also before we add progesterone. So if you do P4 levels, I think 0.5 has cut off. Then you add progesterone and usually it's 10th day. And the maximum is, especially in PCOS patients, it may turn secretory. Maximum is, I think, 14, 15. Maybe in postmenopausal ladies, like a premature menopause, you have a lady who's 40 years of age and you have to do an embryo transfer, egg donation patient. So in that case, you could use it up to 14, 15, 16 days and time it with the endometrial blood flow. That is also very important. I think colored blood flow, color Doppler, simultaneously if you do, would tell you exactly.
Okay.
So minimum 10 days, I think maximum it 15, 16, not more than that.
Okay.
And if you give it more than that, then you will not get good results.
You, I think, showed a study where,
they
I fully understand. So, what was their conclusion? What the best results are? What is the window?
Yeah, the window of implantation. See, there are three four methods. I have tried all of them.